start a panel. Why is this feeding back? That is how you start a panel. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a lot to go through today, so we're going to start even as these guys are coming in the back. We want everybody to get in who can. Thank you so much for coming to join us today. We're excited as that guy to have you. Are the mics hot? Are the panelists' mics on or just mine? Because this will be a very boring panel if it's just me. Sweet, okay. So let me make introductions. To my extreme left is Dennis Reese. He is the producer of Halo Anniversary. To his right is Doug Hiebenthal, who is a founding member of Xbox. You heard me. Founding member of Xbox and executive producer of Halo Waypoint.
Thank you.
To his right, for no reason at all, Gus Arola.
What's up?
And to his right, Kevin Grace, franchise manager, 343 Industries. And my name is Allison Stroll, and we're so happy to have you here. I don't know if you guys heard, but today, Dennis's baby, all y'all's baby, went gold. Did you guys hear that? Anniversary went gold today. Released to manufacturing.
Not his real baby, although they're very special too.
They're also gold.
Yeah.
His are made of platinum. So we're going to get right into the new stuff because we have, like I said, so much to go through. Dennis and Kevin have something to show you.
Yeah. So if you guys don't mind, we thought we might play some Halo for you. Yep. So if you guys can all think back 10 years ago, you started off this game with this guy in this green suit at this opening level called the Pillar of Autumn. Yes! So in honor of being 1 month away from the 10-year anniversary of Halo, we're going back to the start there. And Dennis is going to jump us back into the Pillar of Autumn. He's already gone through, for some of you who ninja'd in early, he went through the opening sequence, and he took the pistol from Captain Keyes, and he's about to get busy. I know. Y'all are rowdy.
Don't keep it loaded, son. You'll have to find ammo as you go.
He's actually a great big liar. He does keep that loaded. So Dennis is going to come out here and is going to show off some of the work that we've done on this opening level of Combat Evolved Anniversary. Yeah. So as you guys can see, this looks a little bit different than how it used to look 10 years ago when you first played the game.
What do you do best?
All these graphic upgrades that we've got on here. Oh! Can we turn that Xbox down just a little bit? There you go. Thanks, guys. All these graphics upgrades that you're seeing right here is 10 years, really, of making games on Xbox, 10 years of making Halo games in particular. But anytime you want to, you can hit that back button, and it switches back to the exact same game, exact same graphics that you had 10 years ago. This is a feature that we started off with kind of as a testing, kind of a, did it really look like that 10 years ago? And we got it actually in there in the game full time. So you can do that all that you want, back and forth. If you want to throw a grenade in 2011, you can hit that button. It'll land in 2001, still blow dudes up, it's fine. So plasma grenade shelf life, actually pretty long. So as he's, Dennis has played this level through building the game like a hojillion times, so he knows all the sneaky grenade tricks. And if he dies, by the way, he owes me a dollar, so I want you all to help me keep track of that.
As Dennis goes through and switches those graphics back and forth, you'll notice, though, that despite all the improvements that we've got in how it looks, all the objects are the same in the game, the encounters are the same in the game. It's actually running the same game as before because, frankly, some things you don't need to mess with. The game was an awesome experience 10 years ago. It's just the same now. So it's the exact same fights, the exact same scenarios that you hit 10 years ago. But looking in a way, nice, that probably might have blown up the original Xbox. No disrespect, Doug Hiebenthal, founding member of Xbox. So as Dennis is playing through, obviously going back and forth on these graphics, you guys may also be able to hear some of the new sound. We've remastered all the combat audio, so those are sounding like with all the quality coming out with games today. And as you were listening to the music as we were coming in tonight, that is a re-recorded version of the original score. Now, obviously, Marty O'Donnell's score is such a big part of Halo that we wanted to go ahead and frankly, spend a lot more money re-recording that with Skywalker Sound. But if you go into the menus, you also have the option of playing it with the classic score, with the one that came with the game the first time around. So, again, it's giving you guys the choice on how you want to play this game, how you want to go back to the beginning after 10 years of Halo. The new graphics, we've got the new audio, we've got the new soundtrack. Obviously, while keeping with the original, some things we haven't changed, like the gameplay, the voice acting is the same. That's still Chief's voice, Cortana's voice, some things you don't want to mess with. We've added some new features as well, like apparently a quiet button in the back. Things like achievements. I don't know if anybody checked out Halo Waypoint recently. The achievements just came out, so you'll finally get your gamer score for taking care of the Covenant on the first Halo. We've got skulls, which we've discussed before, which we don't have active tonight, but in case anybody's keeping track of the skulls that we're talking about, two more of the brand new ones that we're bringing out. One of them is called Recession, which means that every shot that you fire takes up two rounds. So that's going to add a little bit of challenge, and to balance that out, if it's a little too hard for you, is a new skull called Bandana, which gives you unlimited ammo for anything you want. So later on, a little rocket launcher, frankly, the pistol. Honestly, you don't need much more than that pistol with unlimited ammo. That's a good game. We've also got some new story going on here in the terminals. We're not going to be able to show the terminal video today just for time, but if you go up to Halo Waypoint, we've got a couple of those terminals up there. And just like the terminals in Halo 3 and ODST and Reach, that's a way for fans who want to get a little more of the universe to kind of learn more about the story and what's going on behind the game. This story in particular is about that little blue light bulb dude who floats around and follows you, 343 Gopher Spark, where he came from, what he's been up to the last 100,000 years, and where the Halo came from as well. So fans who are brand new to Halo, maybe, I mean, there's a lot of people who play Halo who haven't played this first one ever. Coming in there, it's going to help them understand a little bit more about what they're doing and what's going on around them. But if you've played the game 100 times, you're going to learn some things in those terminals that might blow your mind. And if you're paying particularly close attention, you'll learn some things about the future of Halo that might be involved in little things called Halo 4. So there's a lot of... there's a lot of connection that we're trying to build into this to make sure that we reward both the new fans and the fans who've stuck with Halo for the last 10 years. Because that really is why we did this. It's one of the most popular requests we've had since the 360 came out. Was trying to get a remastered version of the first game and do it justice in today's graphics and today's gameplay. So this really is a big thank you. This is here because of all of you. And it was kind of a nice 10-year happy birthday present for Master Chief. So it'll be a lot of fun on that coming out November 15th. It's 10 years to the day. That's most of the campaign stuff. There's also a whole mess of multiplayer in there. We've got co-op over Xbox Live for the first time ever. So you don't have to... have your friend come over to your house on the sofa and eat all your chips. We've got one new firefight map called Installation 04. For those of you familiar with the campaign, on the second level of the game Halo, you go to rescue a bunch of Marines around... Did you die? Oh, I wanted a dollar. You go to rescue a bunch of Marines around these Forerunner structures, but in this firefight map, you actually go to fight with the Marines, and then they help you out. They actually stick around, and if you jump in the Warthog, they'll get in the turret for you. And gun dudes down. So you picked up an overshield, which means you don't get that one achievement, Dennis. Ha ha. So yeah, so that's Combat Evolved Anniversary on November 15th. I think that's most of the details. Allison, you got any? What did I miss?
Just a couple more things we'll talk about in a little bit.
All right, Dennis,
come home.
Oh, nice. That's a good stand. That's a good close. All right, everybody, cheer for Dennis. He did not die.
Let me bring the lights back up.
I intentionally chose Pillar of Autumn because it's easy to get sticks. You got those corridors. That's right.
Nice. Dennis is famous for self-sticking in public. So, question for you guys. Pillar of Autumn looked awesome 10 years ago, but how do you go from the gray walls of yesteryear to that? Something much more rich and lush and vibrant.
I think that in every one of those scenes, every one of those hallways, you know, starting off from the old graphics, which you can take a look at, hit that back button and check it out, is on all the details, every wall, every barrel, every support, just on that level, and then you get into bushes and trees and halos and moons and stuff like that later on, is we figure that if we do our job right on deciding how those are upgraded to modern graphics, then when you guys hit that button, you're going to say, yeah, that's what that should have looked like 10 years ago if the original Xbox could have pulled it off. So we've got to be faithful to the history of the universe and the history of the game and the franchise. And I mean, obviously Halo's come a long way graphically, obviously before this, all the way from 1 through Reach. But in all that time, I mean, we got to give props to Bungie. They did a really good job of making everything in the universe feel very consistent. It always feels like Halo. I mean, the elites look different from game to game to game, but you look at that dude, and he's an elite, and mostly you need to kill him, except for that one nice one. So we did a lot. I mean, a lot of work. It took, I mean, frankly, a lot more work than we kind of expected going into it to make sure that we did it all right. And it's hard because every Halo fan, their very favorite spot is one of those corridors or one of those rooms, and we have to make everybody happy, and that's a tall order. But hopefully, when you guys get it on the 15th, you'll hit that back button and say, "Yeah, that's what that should have looked like."
First public swearing from Kevin Grace, ladies and gentlemen. You heard it. So people really want to know, like, there's a lot the same. Are the health packs still in the same place? Is my strategy going to change? Am I still going to know where I'm going?
Yeah, the beautiful thing about what we've done here is that it was so important for us to keep that original gameplay intact. So that includes everything from health packs to where the ammo was 10 years ago. It's all still in the same place. We knew that that classic gameplay, as Kevin was saying, is really what made the Halo game so special. And so trying to change that, even in some cases was somewhat tempting, was something that we just weren't going to do. And so, yeah, all that stuff is still intact and
even,
it's going
to
be there.
Even tower to tower, Dennis?
You can, in fact, do tower to tower.
Do we have
However,
any trickers here?
I should say.
Trickers?
I have not tried it myself.
He meant he has tried it but not succeeded.
Yeah.
That's what he meant. We had one more thing we want to talk about in the single player for this. Well, in this part. Yeah. We just want to roll video on this.
This is big. Well, we should probably mention that this is the first time ever that we're talking about this, given any kind of details. You guys get the first look, so yeehaw's there.
Wait, our marketer. Yep. Our amazing marketer over there, Paul Patino's. Wave, Paul. Has asked us to say world exclusive. It is important that this is a world exclusive you're about to see.
Really the first of two tonight. Yeah.
Yes.
If you feel like you've seen everything there is to see in the original Halo, hopefully we've put a few surprises in there that will, well, not change the experience, but make it feel fresh and new all over again.
Got a lot is like, well, Kinect didn't exist 10 years ago and you said you weren't changing the gameplay, so what's going on? The approach to Kinect was actually very similar to our approach to 3D. 3D doesn't work in classic mode, and the reason is there were no 3D TVs 10 years ago, so we wanted to be very conscientious of that. Obviously, Kinect didn't exist 10 years ago, so we wanted to be careful about that.
Kinect for me is actually a really good surprise feature.
So we've got a number of voice commands throughout the course of the game, things like grenade, reload. At the point during the game when you're playing, you can say analyze, and this mode comes up where you can almost capture items. item. So you move your cursor over, say, an elite or a grunt, and in the library, you can go in there and see the things you've captured, move the model around in 3D, and it gives you a bit of a breakdown and explanation of what those characters are.
This is a project that's made by the fans, for the fans.
And I'd be really interested to hear from people who've never played Halo before what their first experience of this ostensibly 10-year-old game is, and how they feel it sits in the pantheon of modern FPS games.
Halo has that epic feel, and getting to play that again is like playing Halo all over for the first time. I hope people have that amazing experience themselves.
So, I want to take you guys home with us. I think you all should come home to Seattle. So what you just saw there is a little bitty one, and the whole, I think, 7-minute version is up on Halo Waypoint. So it's going to be there, I think, Monday. And did you say something wrong with the mic? Okay. No. Monday, sorry. It'll be...
Nobody will know but you until Monday.
Yeah, no, but yeah, shh.
Keep it a huge secret.
So what...
Don't keep it a secret. Tell everybody. That's cool.
So... the features. We heard grenade. We heard analyze. We heard what else? What else are we going to hear?
So Kinect has this great ability with understanding your voice. And so when we sat down and started to think about how to incorporate Kinect into the game, we thought that voice recognition component could be some cool way to add some sort of additional functionality without really changing that gameplay. Because again, gameplay was the core pillar. Keeping it the same and just adding to it was the important thing. And so when we started thinking about this, we really started using, like, well, how about, you know, mapping voice commands to button commands? So for example, if you just say grenade, you throw a grenade. Or if you say reload weapon, you can reload. And, you know, also you can go from classic to remastered, and you just say these things and it happens. And I think that's a lot of fun as you're sitting on your couch, just go reload and have it happen. But another one is the analyze mode. Now, when you say analyze, it pulls up that screen that you saw in the video. And you can find certain things all throughout the game to analyze. And once you analyze them, you store them in the library. And Kevin will probably tell you a little bit more about the library.
Yeah, getting into some of the fiction, you saw a little taste of that with that screen that listed through a number of objects in the game. There's a great big pile of them. For those of you that are familiar with the Halo fiction or any of the things like, I believe this good gentleman up here has an encyclopedia. It's that same kind of adding that kind of depth to the universe and to the game in a way that adds to it. If you've got a Kinect and you want to go in, say, analyze, scan, here's a hunter. Cool. Pulls up a 3D model of a hunter, from the game full. You can rotate it, check it out. It's got some history of the hunters, where they came from, like explaining what these crazy schools of eels in blue armor are about, why they're fighting on the Covenant side. But it was just one more thing that we wanted to add to kind of give you guys, I don't know, a big high five for hanging out with Halo for 10 years. So it's done in a way, like Dennis said, that it doesn't interfere with the original game. If you don't have a Kinect, you still get all the fun in the game, get all the achievements, it's all cool. But if you've got one, then through the voice commands and through the library and the analyzing, it lets you interact with Halo like you've never been able to before, which seemed appropriate for this kind of a celebration.
Cool. In the interest of time, I'm just going to go, speaking of segues, there's a, anybody know what map, multiplayer map, you guys haven't really seen yet?
Sidewind.
Hang 'em high. Who said hang 'em high? So, we want to show you something.
Okay, this is another officially first time ever official announcement.
Official.
Those of you paying attention might have sneaked it out of one or two earlier things, but this is the last of the 6 competitive multiplayer maps that we've got coming. And yeah, fired up. First look here to kind of take everybody back 10 years ago again to Halo 1. That's Hang 'em High. And now that's Hang 'em High. Or High Noon, as the variant is called. It's coming with Halo Combat Evolved Anniversary. So we've done a lot of work. Obviously, all the competitive multiplayer maps are coming over in the Reach engine. So you'll be able to play competitive multiplayer in the Reach hoppers with all your Reach friends, all your Spartan armor, all your armor abilities, all that stuff that makes Reach awesome. But, you know, again, kind of
like the graphics that we saw in the Pillar of Autumn. This kind of stuff just wasn't possible 10 years ago when that first came out. I mean, frankly, or even when we went back to it in Tombstone and Halo 2. So, as you guys know, the view outside has changed quite a bit, but the gameplay, again, it's being faithful to the original, but ported over for Reach. I mean, obviously you got jetpacks, so that's going to change some of the action in here when you go for the sniper rifle, when you go for the rocket launcher. And where everybody is, but this is, I mean, frankly, this is my favorite multiplayer map from Halo 1. I'm really excited, we're all really excited to bring this thing back and to finally get you guys the last of the competitive maps here. So, again, so Hang 'em High, nice. Hang 'em High Anniversary is the map that is built to be as close as possible to the original in the Reach engine. There's going to be, there's going to be some very small details that'll change just because it's been ported over to Reach, but I challenge you to get on that and say that you're not back on Hang 'em High. There's also going to be a variant of that that's called High Noon that our good friends at CA have changed just a little bit, subtly, but to kind of take advantage of map design changes in Halo over the last 10 years. They've added a few new passages. They've added a few sneaky back doors to places that's going to change some of that. And then obviously on the screen there is Forge. We've got Forge objects that'll work in these maps, that work with the palette of these maps. As you can see, that man right there is about to make it go poof. Make it go poof. All right, go poof. Is going to get rid of some of those tombstones, so you guys are going to be able to customize these maps and play with them again, which you know is one of those features that obviously wasn't in that first game, but is a great reason why we wanted to bring these into Reach to give you that level of customization and kind of make these maps your own in a way. So that's the last of the competitive multiplayer maps. We've got our full six, and those are all going to be worked into the Reach Hoppers. If you get Anniversary, you can play those right off the disc, or with Anniversary, you'll be able to download those into the rest of your Reach maps, and then they work seamlessly with the rest of your Reach experience. So you'll play those, all the Anniversary Hoppers, all the normal Hoppers, custom games, all that with those maps.
So can you guys talk a little bit about the map selection process? How you guys chose which ones? I think this is a good one for Gus.
I would go on for way too long and talk way too much about the selection process, so I defer to the producers of the game.
He's a man of great restraint.
The outside perspective is too hazy.
Well, the first thing we did was call Gus. And but really, actually, that's in a roundabout way. We immediately went out to a lot of the fan sites and started looking around, trying to figure out what were the most popular maps. A lot of us had a good idea what it was, but in a lot of cases, you really need to go out. You know, I had my own personal favorite maps, and I just assumed the community liked them, but you kind of need to go out and work with them. And we worked very closely with Certain Affinity in the process as well. And so both of us went off, kind of thought about what maps we'd want to remake, and then came back with our plans, and it turns out a lot of them were kind of overlapped. We knew that we wanted to focus not only on Halo 1 Xbox, but Halo 1 PC, as well as Halo 2. We were really thinking anything that hasn't been remade for the Halo or for the Xbox 360 platform, we kind of wanted to look at those types of maps and bring them up. And I think we did a great job selecting them, ultimately. It was a tough process, but we ended up with six great multiplayer maps, and then, of course, the firefight with the Insulation 04.
So, Dennis, what is your favorite map? You said you had your favorite.
Beaver Creek. Well, Battle Canyon. Love it. Oh, my God. That was one thing I knew as the producer of Halo Anniversary. I mean, I would quit if that map was not in here. I just love it. So much passion for that map. So I had to do a little convincing, but not much.
Not a lot.
No, not much.
Paul just reminded me, and it was a great reminder. So we had two builds on the floor, and one is a secret build that y'all didn't know about until right now, which has Hang 'em High on it. So tomorrow you'll be able to play Hang 'em High, High Noon on the floor up in Xbox land. So I expect to see you there, you, with the doll. You. Wrapping this part up, I just want to remind you all that this, you can pre-order it, it's $39.99 or $95, and $39.99?
$39.99.
And pre-order is a Grunt Funeral Skull and the first ever Master Chief armor. And if you pair it with the Cortana AI chip that came from Halo Fest, it's kind of the perfect thing. So,
and if everybody's actually has heard about the Grunt Funeral Skull, you guys all probably know Grunt Birthday. Yay. Grunt Funeral, however, is after you kill each grunt, they'll fall down for a second, be very sleepy, and then they'll explode just like a plasma grenade, which can set off some pretty awesome chain reactions. I was really hoping Dennis was going to turn it on for the demo today, because right outside the bridge are three grunts right on top, and I was going to get a dollar.
You would have for sure gotten a dollar there. Yeah.
So, why is Gus here, you may ask?
He's dreamy.
Somebody asked.
I want to hear all this new information. It's awesome. Yeah.
It's just a pretty face.
So I believe Gus has something to announce.
Yeah, it's hard to follow the Kinect announcement and the Hang 'em High reveal. Thanks for putting me after the big guns.
Sandwiched. You're sandwiched. It's a Gus sandwich.
Yeah, delicious. You know, we create content that we distribute through Waypoint, and we're announcing a... Well, we had an idea for a series that we wanted to do and release on Waypoint, but we didn't want to call it a mini-series because that implies something small in scope and something, I don't know, something not great, I thought, in my head. So I think maybe Allison came up with a term. We decided to call it the maxi-series. So we are announcing a maxi-series that we're going to kick off on Waypoint, and if any of you were at PAX Prime in Seattle, you saw us do a read-through, a table read-through of the first 10 pages of the Maxi series.
They had it on Waypoint.
Yeah, they did have it on Waypoint. Give that man a dollar.
And that'll be debuting on Halo Waypoint this fall, the Red vs. Blue Maxi series.
Yay! So, while we're on the topic of Waypoint, Doug, I'm looking at you. Waypoint's getting kind of an overhaul as well. Like I told you guys, we have a lot to tell you. Waypoint's getting kind of an overhaul and a re-release this fall as well.
It is a big one. But I wanted to say how excited we are to have the Maxi series on Waypoint.
It's a great place to be. It's a great place to find the Halo community and communicate directly.
You guys hug.
Aww. Hug it out. Dude. Hug it out. Dude.
He wants to hug me.
So one of the things we wanted to do was make it easier to find things like Red versus Blue and all the other cool stuff that's on Waypoint. So we've actually redesigned Waypoint top to bottom. All new web interface, all new console interface, all new Windows Mobile interface. They all look the same now. They're very similar. So if you know how to use one, you know how to use them all. and we've done some other stuff too. So one of the things that's been missing on web has been, anyone? Detailed stats. All the way down to like kills per weapon, kills per enemy, kill death ratio by weapon, all that kind of stuff. That's all going to be here this fall. Nice. So it's a really great improvement on the website. I mentioned user interface stuff already also. You know, you guys heard about terminals. One of the cool things that we're doing is once you've unlocked a terminal, and you have to unlock it, you can come to Waypoint. You can see an HD version of that that terminal, so you can watch it again and again on Waypoint once you unlock it.
Nice.
You know, I can talk a little bit more, but why don't I just show you what the new Waypoint looked like.
Hit it, Paul. Welcome back to Halo Waypoint. This is Allison, here to show you a quick look at some of the exciting features and updates coming to Waypoint this fall. Let's start by taking a look at the all-new Waypoint console. As we dive in, you can see our new redesigned home screen, which puts the world of Halo at your fingertips. Latest and greatest content is front and center, and our rich library is even easier to browse and explore than ever before. Our new Halo store makes it easy to find the perfect avatar gear, DLC, games, toys, and even detailed image galleries of our latest action figures. And of course, the Halo career and reach stats you know and love are right where you left them. Speaking of career and stats, HaloWaypoint.com is bursting with presents like a Grunt birthday party. Yay! All of your reach stats are now available in a powerful and easy-to-use UI that will leave our stat lovers teary-eyed. Slice and dice your stats any way you like, but be careful, the blade is sharp. All of your Reach game history is available as well, with a fresh perspective on the data players want to see most. In addition to all your Halo Reach stats now for the first time on web, you can view all your Halo career data, including your milestone, awards, achievements, and a summary view into your accomplishments throughout every Halo game. Stats and career are not the only areas getting significant upgrades. Thanks to all your great feedback, our forums are getting a major overhaul. And speaking of community feedback, now you can tell us what content you like with a single click. And you can sort that content on Waypoint by community popularity. Of course, Waypoint for your mobile is getting some love as well. We wouldn't leave you in the cold when you're out and about. Be sure to upgrade to the new Windows 7.5 Mango release, and you can upgrade Waypoint as well. We have made the overall experience speedier and prettier, getting you into the content faster and giving you quick access to all of your favorite features. From our new home screen, you have one-click access to our content categories and your career information, including all of your Halo Reach stats. This new version of Waypoint takes advantage of slick new Mango features, like allowing you to listen to Halo podcasts even when you switch out of the app, or allowing you to pin your service record to your start screen for easy access. That was just a quick look at some of the exciting Halo Waypoint goodness coming to console, web, and Windows Phone this fall. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned to Waypoint for more news and updates. Bye. I'm a ventriloquist.
You didn't realize you could be in two places at once, did you? So that's kind of the visual update and some of the stats work that we're doing there. Some really cool stuff. On the web, we've actually created the new website so it'll scale to any size. So all the way from a full Windows screen all the way down to mobile. And if you just resize it as you're going, it just automatically scales to the right place. So it would work on any screen, any size you have. So it's really super cool. But there's one other thing, well, maybe two other things I want to talk about. And these are both the first time we've ever talked about these publicly, but world exclusives. But we're doing two new premium features for this fall. One allows you to create custom challenges all on your own. So we have our daily and weekly challenges now, but now you can challenge yourself and seven of your friends to challenges as well. It's pretty crazy, it's pretty sick. And depending on the type of challenge you create, you can get a little bit of credits, or you can get a lot of credits. The harder they are, the more credits you get, so it's super cool. The other thing that we're announcing for the very first time here is a new thing we're calling Atlas. On your mobile device, you'll be able to actually have a multiplayer strategy guide that allows you to look into the different levels, learn about things like where the respawn points are, where the weapons are stored, those kind of things. But more importantly, when you're in the game, you can see where you and your teammates are in real time. It is wicked cool. In fact, let's
take
a look.
Would you guys like to see that? Well, I think we can accomplish that right now. Hit it, Paul. Say it with me. Hit it, Paul. All right.
Hit Paul.
Welcome back to Halo Waypoint. This is Allison, and today I want to show you two new premium experiences we're bringing your way as part of this fall's update to Halo Waypoint. The first new premium feature I want to show you is custom challenges. You'll be able to create challenges from the web and your Windows 7.5 phone. You will also be able to view progress and accept new challenges from console, web, and mobile. Once you create a challenge, the timer starts right away. So make sure to get into Reach and make some progress. There's no time to waste. Oh, and all the new retro Halo Anniversary maps are supported too. For each challenge, you can see your progress against the goal, along with friends participating in that same challenge. Completed challenges show up in your challenge history, and we can track how many times you've come in first place. Custom challenges add an extra layer of creativity and competition for you and your friends. Of course, I personally find that sometimes playing multiplayer can be challenging in itself. If you share this feeling, you're going to love our new premium Waypoint Atlas experience. Atlas, or Assisted Tactical Assault System, is our new maps and strategy experience, which will be available on Halo Waypoint for Windows Phone and will be a great companion to Halo Reach and Halo Anniversary.
We've partnered with Brady Games to bring you detailed multiplayer and firefight maps for Halo Reach, including Noble, Defiant, and the brand new Anniversary maps. Each map is available in satellite view, as well as illustrated views, which were painstakingly created by Brady artists to give you additional tactical information for each map. You can see weapon locations, vehicles, and important map reference points. And drumroll please, for the first time ever, we're bringing real-time data from your console directly to Waypoint. We've figured out a way to stream your team's position and status straight to Atlas, allowing you to see where each team member is on the map, what weapon they have equipped, whether they're alive and healthy, or in a heap of trouble. By teaching you the maps, weapon locations, and spawn points, Atlas will help you get better even before you play. It'll support you during gameplay with real-time data and status for you and your team. And together with all the stats featured on Waypoint, it'll assist you in becoming a better player so you can truly become legendary. So, as you can see, we're really excited to share these two new premium features with you. Thank you for exploring with me, and stay tuned to Halo Waypoint for more news and updates. See ya!
So as you can expect, we're super excited about both those new features. What do you guys think? Excellent. Well, we really like taking Waypoint to the future and really continue to improve it. And I think you'll see some more and more stuff from us as we go ahead. So let us know what you think.
So I guess my main question, Doug, is is this going to mean I don't stink at Slayer anymore?
Well, while we think that this tool is good for helping people learn how to play better, learn the maps better, do all that kind of stuff, I don't think there's any help for you on this one.
No, seriously, she's really bad. It's true.
I'm awful. So that gives us a few minutes for Q&A. So are there
mics?
There's a mic right there. And is that the only mic?
I think it's the only mic.
Okay. Line up slowly. Be nice to one another.
No trampling.
No trampling.
No need to run. We're all friends. Proceed calmly.
Gus, do you want to tell us a joke while everybody lines up?
Wow. That's that's like the worst thing you can say to someone.
You could say something awfully unfunny.
That's an excellent idea, sir. Oh, that's an excellent idea, ma'am. World exclusive first ever griff. Saluting a female superior officer.
All right, that's a long line. So, hit it, young man.
I actually have two questions, quick questions.
First, they better be quick, my friend.
Are you going to be able to use the back button in cutscenes?
In custom games?
In cinematics, there's actually slight differences between the original cinematic timing and the new cinematic timing, so we weren't able to actually make that transition. So once you start a cinematic in Legacy, you will remain in that until you get out of it, or if you start it in Remastered, you'll be in Remastered graphics the whole time.
So it's not as easy to switch, but you still get the option to
exactly.
watch it
yeah,
however
you want.
Yeah,
you'll be able to watch Cinemax either way you want. It's just you have to switch before you get to them.
And one for Gus. Is Red vs. Blue going to move to Anniversary, or are they going to stick with Reach?
When you say move to Anniversary, do you mean like remake all of our existing stuff?
Because
I'm not doing that again.
The answer to that is yes. He's going to remake everything all himself.
But I mean, we of course we'll definitely look at the maps, the multiplayer maps. We'd love to revisit some of these. For example, there is a map. I'm not going to name it, but it's the one Caboose's Mind. Maybe we'll see some scenes back there again, and maybe the Zealots will come back now that we have a Beaver Creek remake. But it definitely leaves openings. I'm not saying it's going to happen.
He said it's going to happen.
Rooster Teeth,
but it may
we should say that Rooster Teeth also did a fly-through per map for us that we're going to air every 7 days coming up to, right? The week before launch, the 7 days up to launch.
I had to suffer, and I had to go to Certain Affinity and play all the maps all day so we could do fly-throughs.
I know. Poor Gus. He has a really hard job, you guys. Seriously.
Super hard
Gus's
work.
Gus's job is so hard.
Thank you.
Evening. My question is, will there be a thirsty grunt? The Easter egg.
A thirsty grunt.
A thirsty
the one,
grunt?
The one that wants a food nipple.
We have, we're not going to give away everything today about Easter eggs, but we have kind of along the same lines as all the other bits and pieces we've talked about with the graphics and the sound and all that. We've stayed very true to some of the Easter eggs in there, and we've added a little bit of new stuff too. So we're not going to go through them piece by piece, but anybody who was paying really close attention to Dennis's demo earlier might have seen some of those new Easter eggs. So,
so
I guess we'll find out later.
Maybe you'll find an Easter omelet.
Never know.
Thank you.
There. Trademark. Trademark. There is definitely fun to be found.
Good. All right. Hey, evening. For the analyze thing for the Kinect, I noticed in the video that there, the X button, it said play next to it. And I was wondering if that meant like you could use your Kinect to like manipulate the model itself.
No.
No.
Just my well, you can rotate it so you can kind of check it out from all the angles, and it's kind of posed from in-game, but you can't.
Yeah, like, so the motion like, you make kind of like act like a bird. Dance? Yeah.
Elite Dance Central, yeah. Is that what you're looking for?
No. Yeah, you will be able to actually use Kinect at menu navigation within the library, as well as take a sort of a better look at the actual you know, grunt or elite, whatever you've recorded, so you can spin it and stuff with there.
Did everyone see Dennis's bird there?
Yeah, it was a good bird.
It was pretty good.
Cool. How's it going? I had a question for yeah, thanks.
Kick ass.
Or maybe if I can move this up. I'm just too tall. I'm sorry. I had a question for the multiplayer. For the vehicles, I remember in the first multiplayer for Halo Combat Evolved that they're indestructible. Will they still be indestructible in this one?
They will be indestructible in the campaign. Again, because that gameplay is the same, but because the competitive multiplayer is in Reach, they'll behave the same as they currently do in Reach. Okay. So so not indestructible in competitive multiplayer, but in campaign, go nuts.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Yeah.
You know, I forgot to say, we talked a lot about Waypoint and Waypoint content. I don't know if any of you guys like the motion comics or have seen the motion comics that we run. Have any of you guys seen those? Yeah. Did you guys ever see Headhunter? Did you see that one? The guys in the back there, stand on up. More frames. Those guys made that.
Hi, guys.
Yay. All right, sit down. Okay, hit it.
Your 13 seconds of fame is over.
Yeah, done.
Can we expect any new multiplayer map packs before Halo 4, including other old Halo maps?
Right now we're just focusing on these maps, the six that are coming out with Anniversary, because six all at once, I mean normally map packs are a bit smaller than that, so this is a pretty big pile, and getting this and then really focusing our attentions on Halo 4 afterwards is all that we're looking at and talking about right now.
Okay, thank you.
Yep. Hi, that's the cover art for the game, because I know Master Chief's model has changed since then.
Yeah, the scheduling on creating box art and all the details on that, you know, the sausage making, we don't want to do that, but
Paul.
No, that's not Paul's fault. That's not in charge of reality, where you have to like
it's
make things.
It's not all Paul's fault. Yeah. Come on.
Most of it's Paul's fault.
Okay, a lot of it's Paul's
fault. All right,
fault.
Okay, Paul's fault.
But yeah, his armor has changed a little bit since then. I mean, I think that you guys have seen some of the videos that have been out since then. So they released Dennis in particular, who's gone back and forth to Russia more times than we can count. I mean, we're getting every single bit into this game as we can before actually just today, honestly. Until today, it was crazy times, getting it as perfect as possible until we went gold and started getting ready to send it to you. So we didn't waste any time trying to make things better. So we kept on working on Chief all the way up to the end, all the levels all the way up to the end, all the features, Kinect, everything. To make it as good as we can for you on the anniversary. So yeah, so he's changed a bit, but we still think that cover art looks pretty sweet. So,
unfortunately, technology has not gotten to the point where you can hit the back button and change your cover art.
Yes. Oh my God, that would be great.
Right.
We just new feature. Let's that TM yet. That shit
trademark.
Right now.
Language miss.
Thank you. Hey, for matchmaking, will 1v1 be brought back?
We're doing that for the anniversary.
anniversary hoppers?
I don't remember.
You stumped
him. And what was the issue, why it was taken down?
It's a great question. Can we get back to you?
Yeah.
That's what I'm... Okay.
Anniversary.
You come back to Waypoint, and we will have an answer up for you. We'll have BS Angel get you some scoop on 1v1 directly. So right.
I wish I had a prize to give the man who stumped.
That ain't fair. There's a lot of questions out there.
All right. Thank you.
Yep, thank you.
Hi. First, I want to say thanks for just making Halo. It's been such a huge part of my life since I started ten years ago.
For, yeah.
I know Bungie, well, but like Bungie. You know, yeah, yeah. Still though, for continuing it and everything and bringing it back, and it, just thank you for that. And what can we expect in terms of, like, you said you were doing stuff about the Halo PC. Is there what from Halo Halo 1 PC is going to come over to Halo Anniversary Edition?
Well, the Anniversary Edition is, I mean, this is the original Xbox version.
Okay.
Some of the multiplayer maps, like Timberland, for example, mm-hmm. came over from Halo 1 PC. We wanted to draw with the maps from the original Halo, Halo 1 PC, and Halo 2. So we've kind of got a nice little sampling from all those places. But otherwise, this is absolutely the Xbox game that we played 10 years ago, or some of us more recently. I'm making myself sound old, but it's still that very same Xbox game.
All right. Thank you.
I thought Timberland was a good choice. It was a little unexpected when I think of the original Halo.
Yeah,
I was thinking of the Xbox release, and that was a great map from the PC version.
Well, I mean, vehicles are fun, and it's a nice big open space to take advantage of them, and still a blast. Still dangerous if you're sloppy around the corners. So.
Okay, just a couple of comments. When I was first played as the Arbiter in Halo 2, it got me thinking that I would be playing as other Covenant species in later games. If you think you're going to explore the possibility of doing that?
Well, obviously, what we've shown off on Halo 4 so far has to do with Master Chief, obviously coming back into the action. And I think we all had a good time with the Arbiter in Halo 2. But right now, we're talking about Master Chief. And kind of getting him back into the fight. So nothing to talk about for getting into any Covenant species otherwise right now.
Doing that space battle in K-Reach's campaign was kicked ass. Really did.
Thank you. Actually, one other thing I might mention for any Covenant sympathizers out there is that we do have a new book coming out. Karen Travis's Glasslands is landing in very, very short order. And for anybody who's curious about what's going on in the Halo universe after Halo 3, and in some of those settings where Master Chief might be hanging out, that might be an interesting read. She's done actually a really great job, and it's a messy place, the universe, at the end of Halo 3. And there's some interesting... Oh, dude, check these guys out. They got a couple from Tor, who was handing them out earlier. So,
oh, nice!
Get them.
I haven't seen them.
Nobody get them, Gus. So if you ask those guys really nice, they might tell you a little bit about it. But it's a really good book. And it's a really exciting addition to the universe. We're really excited to have Karen come on board with us.
Yeah, I hope if you were those in-game space battles. And also, that delightful...
Wait. Look at all those people behind you. We only have 5 minutes left.
Okay, fine. Tell Mountie to keep up the good work.
Okay.
We'll
thank
do.
You.
Thank you.
All right. I know how you guys retooled the pistol for Anniversary Edition and made it as strong as it was in the first game. And I'm a bit of a needler whore. So did you fix this, like, the targeting on that and the power on that or not?
Gus?
I always found the needler to be good comic relief. It's like, oh, you're going to kill me? I'm going to shoot around you. So I hope the targeting stays the same and stays authentic and original for comedy's sake.
All right.
There you go. Good answer. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Hi.
I think it was a great answer.
One in campaign. Can you play with your friends, like, up to 4 people, like, in Reach and 3?
No, we've got we do have co-op over Xbox Live, but it's 2 players. I shouldn't say only 2 players. The original game was designed for 2-player co-op, and that was one of the things that we looked at in the course of development was, do we want to add to get up to 4 to bring it up to parity with Reach? But if you add 2 more people in there, you really need to change the gameplay. You need to change the encounters, because like a fight that's fun for 2 people and challenging is a cakewalk for 4. And that would have involved going in and cracking and changing where they placed all of the enemies and where they, you know, all those encounter spaces, and that was something that we weren't going to do because
yeah,
we
even
wanted
in
to keep
the
that
opening
true.
Cinematic, I mean, if you're playing co-op, you'll have two cryotubes, two yeah. Master Chiefs popping out, right?
Yeah.
So there's all these little things that we have to take into account aside from gameplay, which is that core mechanic we did not want to change.
And also in Firefight, will we have Firefight voices again?
I'm sorry, will we
what?
Have
was the question?
Will we have Firefight voices, like in Reach?
Yes.
Will we have some Red versus Blue?
We hate those guys, so probably not.
Please.
Just mixed. Download our podcast and listen to it. It'll be the same, like the yeah. same thing.
While you're playing.
Yeah, while you're
the
playing.
The newly rebranded podcast. I am totally starting my own Drunk Tank podcast.
I've got two super quick questions. One, it was said that the Kinect wasn't going to be necessary to enjoy all the features in Anniversary. So what button is mapped to Analyze by default?
So Analyze will only be available if you have Kinect.
It will.
It will be only be available if you've got Kinect, but again, it's one of those things that we've added to the experience. So going back in, you get the absolute game that you had before, but this is one of the additional things. So yeah, okay. So it won't be available if you don't have Kinect, but you've got the encyclopedia. There's some other options out there. So we have
all
some,
the information's yeah. on the Halo Waypoint.
Again, it's one of those things where if we added a button for Kinect, then we get into what did that button used to do, and getting into all fiddling right. with some of that gameplay.
Look
so
what Gus brought.
It was not. I mean, it wasn't an easy call, honestly. As we wanted to try to find
not.
A way to make it work. But
okay. Yeah. The other thing is, both for Rooster Teeth and for 343, where are your job listings?
There's actually on Halo Waypoint at the bottom. If you go all the way down to the bottom, it says 343 jobs. Bam. Click on that. It'll
I look at them
site.
All the time.
Yeah.
and we know.
Is Rooster Teeth doing any kind of internships or anything?
Track your IP.
Gus, is Rooster Teeth doing any kind of internships or job openings? Yeah.
Yes. If you read our FAQ, you can find all that information. Roosterteeth.com/FAQ.
Thank you.
Thanks. Right on.
Good questions. Even the one we didn't like.
Hello there.
Hello.
First off, I have two questions, but they're similar. They involve the short stories in the motion comics. Mm-hmm. Will there be more of the stories, but based on the bigger books like Fall of Reach? If not the whole book, like some of your favorite chapters?
Can't announce anything. We don't have anything that we're talking about right now. But if we were to make one, what would you like?
Well, I do like Contact Harvest and Cold Protocol.
I like those too.
And another one, I noticed in the Mona Lisa that some of the motion looked more regular animation than just motion comic. Will there be some of those stories actually in other formats like live action or animation? Not anime, but regular animation like cartoons.
Same answer. We don't have anything to talk about right now about it. But I'm glad that you like it. We love it.
One thing, I mean, that is anniversary related is if you go up to Waypoint and check out the videos for the terminals, those kind of started, the theory was that those were going to start as motion comics, kind of like the ones that we've done on Waypoint elsewhere. But the guys at the sequence group kind of went way above and beyond, and they turned into pretty much just straight animation and some really cool things that we've never seen before in the Halo universe. So
yeah, it's kind of
anniversary is going to have a pretty good taste of that for you, if that's what you're looking for.
Yeah, if you can't get enough comics, terminals is your thing.
Thanks.
For right now. Thank you for asking. I think we have one more question. Two more questions.
Paul,
sorry,
Paul
guys.
Paul said two.
Dos mas.
We're good. Okay. So
Paul said two?
Paul.
And we all know Paul's in charge.
Motion main. I don't know. So I'm a huge fan of obviously the whole series as it's gone along. I think some of the decisions Bungie's made in the last few years have been a little questionable sometimes. Really happy about what 343 has done so far. But what do you guys do with the music? Where's Marty? I know he's not in 343.
Marty's at Bungie.
Yeah, so who's the next?
Yeah, that's, I mean, I gotta admit, those are great big shoes to fill. Obviously, Marty's tunes are a huge part of what's made Halo kind of the iconic experience that it is. And so we've got a lot of work to do. I mean, a lot of those things. Obviously, Bungie's did such an amazing job with Halo in the first 10 years in music, in design, in art, and all that kind of stuff. And our job is to give you guys a Halo 4 and a 5 and a 6 that's at least as good, or if we do our jobs right, better. So, yeah.
And we talk a little bit about the music in the Halo 4 panel from Halo Fest. Tajin is up there, so if you go back to Halo Waypoint and look at that, they address a little bit of that question a little bit more with the guy who's charged with doing it.
But in the meantime, we did double down on Marty for anniversary, so you get two servings.
Two Martys for the price of one.
Thank you.
Thanks.
It sounds like Waypoint's an excellent destination for all the Halo news you need.
Doesn't
it? This guy.
This is his last question, so there's no pressure.
No pressure.
Make it good.
God damn it.
Yes!
First of all, thank you. Everyone in this room thinks you're all fantastic. So, get that out.
Oh, wait, he's about to hit us hard. Do you feel this?
Good start. Well, good start.
But for real.
Here we go.
When is the title update for Reach Multiplayer going to be finalized, and what kind of feedback have you been getting about Zero Bloom?
That guy wants to know, too. Gus?
Everybody on the internet loves it universally, just the same. It's super easy. No.
Yeah.
Actually, we've been getting a lot of great feedback. It certainly has opened up some issues that we're looking at. One of the beautiful things about the way that Bungie architected the multiplayer system, in particular the hoppers, is we can go in and we have a whole bunch of settings that we can tweak on as we learn more about what the title update has introduced. So we're doing that right now. We're continuing to work on that. Part of my team's responsibility is to manage that. So I think you'll see some interesting minor twists and changes to kind of tweak it in. But overall, I think the feedback we're hearing loud and clear is the TU is a big improvement over no TU. And the Zero Bloom is an interesting addition that changes some things. And overall, I don't think we can completely recover from the change, but net plus is bigger than minus.
And when will the title update be finished?
Well, the title update, I think what you're referring to is when the hoppers
might
be beta.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do we have a date for that?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, yeah.
I can leave it down.
I mean, November 15th, right, is when everything goes live, so that's the day that we go from no longer being beta to being final.
Thanks.
And remember for sure that this is just the beginning of how we're going to be monitoring kind of the health of Reach online and multiplayer and making some of these kinds of changes. And like Doug said, we are absolutely, you guys saw the note in the video earlier about the Waypoint forums improving and what we're using your feedback to do. So if you have thoughts on it, express it respectfully and nicely, as everybody does on the internet. But but do that, because we're just getting started with this and we're going to keep improving it and keep making things better.
I think we should
you.
Close with Kevin Grace singing his favorite internet song.
No, we don't want to sing any songs. It's okay to not like things.
Come on, Kevin! Sing! Kevin!
Kevin!
Man, Allison's in trouble. So you guys have seen the YouTube video, the It's Okay to Not Like Things? It's okay, but don't be a dick about it?
Yeah.
Anyway, I think that's the
best song ever. It's okay to not like things, don't be a dick about it. We love you! Thank you for coming.
Thanks, guys, for coming.
Outside.
Enjoy Halo Anniversary, November 15th. Happy birthday, Master Chief.
We'll be outside if you guys want to talk a little bit more.